Years later is a series where I take a look back at past pop culture and cinema and see if films that are 10 or more years older still hold up. Today's episode will be on The Fast and the Furious. It was released on June 22nd, 2001. So, does it hold up?
What year is it?
Whoa, what?
Thursday.
What year?
No, what year is it?
When I was watching The Fast and the Furious, this is like a time capsule, a movie of its time, because immediately the music, I heard like Limp Bizkit's rolling and just the music that was used. It was like, okay, yeah, this is definitely a early 2000s movie that I remember watching because I think my cousins had it on DVD, but that wasn't really into it. It was just about street racing and all that stuff and about family, I guess, which is, again, this movie is very grounded compared to F9. I just saw the trailer for that.
What a day!
Like flying cars in space or something like that. It's gonna get crazy. I haven't seen any of the movies, only parts of them, but I don't remember which one. It's enjoyable, it's fun, you know, kind of jarring to see that this is a street level race movie. As the intro goes on, it just gets crazier and crazier from what I've heard. If you got Paul Walker, you got this guy who has like a red truck, he also has another car that's green. A disclaimer, I don't know shit about cars, so if I say something wrong about cars, apologize for that, because I know nothing about them whatsoever. Paul Walker, he's hitting up a girl at a bar or something. Her name's Mia, Dom's sister. We even see Dom in the background. He seems to be kind of like the lead family of this whole family thing. And then his family start coming in and they start messing with Paul Walker because he's in some kind of company. They have a fight. Dom stops it. And so Paul Walker's character, I think his name is Brian. I think it is. I think it's Brian. Either way, his character is basically like out of his element. He's coming into this neighborhood not knowing what to do. He has no idea what he's got himself into, especially street races and the people that he's going to get involved with, and how crazy he's going to get with the whole cops and whatnot. So I like that aspect. But his character himself, as far as right now, as far as the first film, it's fine. You know, it's decent. He's that guy, comes in and ruins or helps people in this sort of city or town. He's that character. Marlo Dom and Vin Diesel's character, he's already this established person within his home family and group. It seems to be the lead, the head, chief or whatnot. But that will play a big part in, I guess, loyalty and family. This whole movie is about loyalty and family, because Paul Walker saves him, saves Dom from the cops in this kind of ridiculous great race thing where there's like a bunch of valves that have to switch on. I think Vin Diesel, no, Paul Walker has like a monitor that has like the 3D model thing or whatever. Like, what? Okay, this is back in 2001. All right. And then there's a bunch of big tubes and shit. It's like, okay, this is kind of ridiculous. It's still grounded a little bit. They're just driving blurry lines, like anime lines on the background, you know. Okay, this is kind of cool. Paul Walker loses, to be expected. He's new and fresh into this. However, the cops show up because it is illegal to do this whole street racing thing, as everyone just runs away. But Dom is saved by Paul Walker and he brings him into the family. And you know, not every family member is gonna like that from Dom's decision, especially the one guy that caused a fight between him, Paul Walker. But Dom allows him to stay because he saved his life while the rest of his family wasn't there for him whatsoever. So that plays into the whole loyalty family and kind of Paul Walker's character being kind of a needle and like, just, it's kind of like a plot thread, or maybe not a plot thread, but he's like interrupting the flow of the family, essentially just being like, what is this guy doing? He's fresh and new, doesn't know what the hell he's doing. And then he also decides to hit on Mia again. So it's like he's invited his family, he's hitting on Dom's sister, but then he gets confronted by the cops that they could work within the inside and help take down Vin Diesel and his family because they're known as criminals. And so again, the whole loyalty part, like, it's like, what does he do? Does he choose his new family member that he was just introduced to, wants to get this girl named Mia, or work for the cops? And he has to make that decision. Came in interesting because this movie is interesting, but it's definitely like, all right, you know, characters are fine, street race cool, family loyalty, and then the whole working in undercover thing adds a little intrigue to that. But in the end, he obviously chooses Vin Diesel and his family because he ain't gonna betray them. There's that one dinner scene where they're all sitting, Paul Walker's getting out by that one guy because he doesn't like him. And then in terms of like sequences, again, that first racing was cool but a bit ridiculous, but I was like, you know, I like this. I think my favorite one is the last one where they're going up and down the roads and hills and whatnot, being chased by those guys in motorcycles, and Paul Walker and Dom are taking them out one by one, whether it's killing them or not, whatever, who cares, they're being taken out, whatever. This obviously creates a bond and makes them come closer, becoming more family, creating that loyalty unlike some of his current members or family members. And the Dom's like race car, it looks cool. Like, again, I'm not a car person. The only car I love is 1967 Chevy Impala, Supernatural, everyone. But like, it's a cool looking car. It has that one thing in front, which, again, don't know my car terms, but it looks cool. But there's not like, again, that was my favorite one, but it didn't really like excite me anyway. It was just like, okay, this is cool. Like, it seems like this movie was supposed to be like just kind of underground, just kind of chill racing car movie. That's the impression I got. It wasn't supposed to be kind of this over the top ridiculous stuff that it was meant to be later on, but it's definitely like, it's a very simple story, family, loyalty, and like respect. And that's really it. There's like two car races. He wants to go with this girl named Mia, his sister. Paul Walker is tested with his limits and loyalty. loyalty, whether he wants to choose new family, cops, or himself. I like that. Jealousy within the family, that's alright, that's cool. Vin is being the head, he's cool as well. Like, there's that one character that I love. They were all just alright. What kept me through is the ridiculous car, with the first car chase, and the whole loyalty and family aspect. I was like, this is cool. I've always heard that the franchise was about family, and right from the beginning, it's been about family, because, again, he has to choose his new family, his loyalty is being tested. In the end, both of the car crashes, they just kind of walk it off, and it ends with the whole end credits with very 2000s music. Took me back to like early 2000s vibe. So in the end, the Fast and the Furious, 20 years later, still holds up. Still an enjoyable film, fun film about family, but just kind of an overused theme I've been noticing. Granted, family is important, but it's like, god damn, not every TV show or movie has to do that theme, but it's fun, it's good, it's decent. So that's it for me. This has been The Road So Far, and thank you for watching.